Hello and welcome back to Asian Hour, bringing the top stories and the top topics from around the Philippines. In this video, we're going to talk about, I'm going to tell you a story of a man who sent money to a Filipina for 6 years just to find out she had a husband all along. Stick around till the end. I'm going to tell you my personal thoughts and experiences in the Philippines about sending money online. Here's today's story. Guys that are chatting with Filipinas online, please, please don't send money to someone who you never met in person. I know there are a lot of good girls in the Philippines. I recently found out my wife's sister's best friend was involved with an American man. For 6 years, they were chatting every night. This man, I would call him Mr. Wilson, was sending 180 USD every month to this lady until last month he sent his tax refund to her, 1980 USD. Mr. Wilson never came to the Philippines. He had to take care of his mother who was sick. The Filipina has now ghosted this guy. With all the money she received from, she was able to build a house and a small business for her and her husband and two children. Please don't be this fool. All right, kind of a heartbreaking story. I'm gonna hold off because I really wanna start talking, but let's read some comments first. But before we do that, take a quick second. If you're new to the channel, just hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. It's completely free, but it really motivates me to make these videos. Here's the top comment. Someone says, there will be a plot twist. The girl ghosted him to focus on her business. In a few years, it will become one of the most successful business in the Philippines. She will pay Mr. Wilson all his money back and give him an extra million as a gift for helping her. With that, Mr. Wilson will be able to come to the Philippines and find the love of his life. Call me an optimist. A lot of people just laughing at that comment. I don't know if it's sarcasm or somewhat like a hint of truth to it, but even if that was true, what is he gonna do with her husband or two kids? But all jokes aside, so this is not something new. Of course, there's gonna be many stories. I think there's a whole show called Rafa Telfo something. Anyways, I don't watch it, but the point is, nobody ever talks about all the successful stories. I mean, they do actually, but it doesn't get that much focus and highlights because it's not exciting. Let's be honest. People like drama, people like gossip, and it's just entertaining and somewhat deep down a little sickening for us to kind of get a little bit of joy in someone else's misery or think that other people are stupid because they're not in that situation. So these kinds of stories get a little bit more light and more attention sometimes when it does happen. Now, who's to say this story is even true? But let's just hold this at face value. Let's believe this story. For 6 years, this person was receiving money, $180, which is around 10,000 pesos. Now, 10,000 isn't a whole bunch of money, but it's enough to make a difference for someone in the Philippines. As in this case, the person was able to build a home and a business. Let's read the next comment. Someone says, the man is an adult and it's his money. Whether he got something in return or not still isn't my business or anyone else's. All the facts are not known and doesn't matter. I don't really agree with that, right? I mean, if there was an agreement where the guy paid $180 just to speak to somebody on a regular basis, yeah, for sure. That's like a service you're paying for being lonely. Completely fine. I support the woman. But the problem is when somebody is misled, right? We don't really know what the circumstances were. If she pretty much strung him along for 6 years saying, oh, we're gonna meet. But how do you talk to somebody for 6 years and not see them? That is something I can't excuse. To be honest, I can't get over that. I don't understand people that have these long distance relationships for years, like years, 6 years. Like, what are you doing, man? You're wasting your life talking to somebody online. Get your ass on a plane and go see her, right? So I know people say, oh, money's tight, money's tight. Well, save up, man. If money's tight now where you can't even afford a visit to the Philippines, how do you think it's gonna be when you actually get there or when she gets to the US or wherever? It's not gonna work out. So get out there, get on a plane and meet the person you're talking to online, because you can sort out so many things by actually meeting the person. Who knows, maybe online is a whole different person than reality, right? Some people have excellent chemistry online, but when they get together face to face, there simply isn't anything there. Or maybe there's some like things that you didn't know before. Maybe she doesn't even like you, right? Maybe you're not the same guy, right? So that's why it's crucial to meet somebody online. I'm gonna get into detail about that at the end, but let's go on to our next comment. A woman says, I respect your perception regarding what you saw, but in 6 years had not noticed all about them. This guy's a fool. Send her money all along without knowing her situation. That's impossible, you know. I've been experienced a good men in other countries, even though they knows about women's situation, they still help without question, without demanding or asking anything, but a pure heart to help. If you don't help and understand between, posting here with proof is so that both could give their side by side. It's none of your business, sir. Real men not easily judged, but they're safe. I know there's a lot of smart and open-minded persons here, but please be careful posting about Filipina women. Don't be so rude, just saying. I get the gist of that. I guess she's saying there's some good men that send money knowing the situation. That's what I was kind of saying earlier, right? Because when you post something like that, not all women are the same in any country, right? But it does get a bad reputation because a lot of people online are becoming this kind of woman. Let's just be honest, not just the Philippines, everywhere around the world, women have access to these devices now, but they don't really find a need to meet somebody without getting financial support, right? So sometimes perhaps the age gap is just not enough, but they enjoy talking to you and they may just want some money from you. Let's go on to our next comment. Filipina P has several scammer videos. One retiree talked to a girl online for 5 years, even met her mother online. He sent her money to build a house and buy a car. When he finally came over to the Philippines, the girl, her mother, house, or car could not be found. At the time of the post, he was flat broke, spending his entire retirement funds, which he had cashed out. His total loss was about 4 million USD. Yeah, so the Filipina P is a very popular vlogger in the Philippines. She's a Filipina woman talking about dating and other kind of videos. So I guess in one of her videos, somebody got scammed for $4 million. Come on, man. Like, if you're that stupid, let's just be very, very frank. If you're a man that desperate in need of attention, love, and affection, or just sex, spending $4 million USD on somebody, I'm just going to come out and say, you deserve to get scammed. Like, how stupid are you, man? Come on. What are you doing? Like, I can't even, I'm so angry right now. Come on. I don't want to blame the victim, but at some point, you got to start taking some responsibility for your actions. And our last comment, someone says, I second this. If not sending money is going to affect your online relationship, then this is the wrong relationship. All right, so with that being said, my thoughts on this matter about sending money online to a woman you never met. Personally, it's too much to get into right now. It's never going to be a simple answer. Let's just start with the basics. If you're talking to somebody which is within your like age range, let's say within 5 years, right? Let's say you're 40 and she's somewhere between 35 and 45, then that's basically considered equal grounds. You should never be sending money to somebody like that. Even if you never met her or she asked for it, if you met somebody online, I would never recommend sending money because there's no need for it. If you're older and you're talking to somebody younger, she got to go to school or whatever, then at that point, your money is basically what you have to offer because it's not really your looks. So let's be frank, if you're a senior and you know it's a 50-year gap between you two, then obviously she's in it for something more than just physical appearance. It's different when you're younger. Let's say you're in your 20s and you're both in your 20s. Somebody can get over the fact that you don't have money because at that stage of your life, you're kind of both in the same boat. You're still trying to find your footing. And money is really not an issue because you can have a good time eating at McDonald's or something like that. But as you get older, money does become important because money provides security, right? And women need security. It provides comfort. It provides your home. It provides, maybe if they're going to have kids, they want to know they're going to be able to support that person. Now, for me personally, I never understood how people can talk to somebody online for months or years on end if they're not going to be there. I personally can't do it because it's just like, imagine being hungry, going to a buffet, but you can't touch the food. You can just smell it for the next 6 months. I can't do that, man. So my thoughts, my hints or my advice to you guys is don't talk to women online until you're ready to come to the Philippines in a month. Let's just say in 2 months or something. But everybody's different, right? That's just me, right? You could be okay with talking to somebody all day, all night. And sometimes if women are honest up front, men don't mind. They'll just send money if they know, like, let's say there's no relationship, but they just like the attention. There's so many angles to get into. It's going to depend on whether you're single, how long you've been single, if you're divorced, how old you are, if you have money, if you don't have money. And from the woman's side, as long as you're not misleading somebody, good for you. Go for it. Get money. Why not? If I was a woman, I'd want to make money too, right? Like, without having to do the work. Like, why work hard when you can work smart? If somebody's dumb enough, if a man is stupid enough to send you money for 6 years straight, hey man, take advantage of that. I'm being very, very frank and honest. Like, you guys got to smarten up. Men got to start being men and stop, like, putting the on a pedestal, right? Like, excuse my language, but it is what it is. Like, if you're going to make that your main focus, you're going to get taken advantage of because you don't see what's around that. You just see the one thing that you're pretty much tunnel vision on the whole time. And nowadays, women, they know how to play the game. They know how to work this thing because it's not just you they're talking to. There's probably a dozen guys in her inbox and her DMs, and who knows who's sending her the most money. So you're going to fall down that pecking order. And if you're a guy like me that doesn't even pay women attention, like, then you're going to not do well online. Because for me, at least, if somebody ignores me, if there's any red flags, I just ditch them. I don't tolerate that. I'm not at that stage in my life where I'm desperate enough to just pay for someone's attention, right? So I'm not talking now to anybody, to the guys or the women, but I'm just saying how the reality of dating somebody online is. You got to ask yourself, why is she online, first of all? Like, why is she talking to men in a different country? What is the point of that? Does she not have any suitors in her own local jurisdiction, let's say? Her friends, her coworkers, her colleagues? Even if she doesn't have a job, these guys that are wrong. Why is she not dating a Filipino? Right? What is up with these women saying, oh, I don't date Filipinos because they're heartbreakers? That's just an excuse, right? I talked to a lot of men in the Philippines. And men are men all across the world, so it doesn't matter which country you're coming from. We're pretty much very straightforward It's crazy to me. It blows my mind. I'm rambling at this point, but leave your thoughts down below. Let me know what you think of this story, or if you have any other stories of men sending money. Basically, to sum it all up, don't send money online. I don't care how much you like this person. If you never met her, you don't know who she is. You don't know what she's doing. And as a woman, if you can basically get money without misleading someone, just be honest. Say, hey, I'm a student. I can talk to you regularly. I'll send you a tit picture or something. You give me $100 a month. And if he's okay with it, then do it. Do it to a 10, 20 guy, whatever. I don't care. As long as you're being honest and upfront. The thing that bothers me is these women that just basically mislead men and say, oh, I want love. I want true love. I want a man to take care of me. He puts his whole life into it and then comes to the Philippines just to find out she has like a husband or a kid that he wasn't aware of, or just doesn't want to meet him. Plain and simple. Yeah, so that's that. Not a really happy ending to that story, but there's a lot of other positive stories in the Philippines. I'm sure there's hundreds of videos, and there's a whole groups of like happy relationships. So don't let this kind of like, I don't know, turn you off about dating Filipinos, but you got to be aware, man. You got to have your head on right. You got to just like take things as they are. If somebody sounds like they're full of shit, call them out. See if they are. They just like, don't ignore red flags. I've done like a few videos on red flags on my main channel, but like, I don't know. Man up.